One of the significant, the original goals of Sidney Resources as a corporation is to change the way mining is done. You know, we've worked on, we have some laser technology that we've been developing, but really it's about changing the way mining practices are done.
All right, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. And joining me now is Dan Hally. He's the COO of Sidney Resources. And Dan, it's great to have you back again. How are you?
Well, I'm doing well, and it's great to be back.
Yeah, I'm excited to get a bit of an update on where the company's at with your project. I know there's a lot of work going on right now. We've got a lot to cover, but just let's remind everyone a little bit about the project itself. Talk us through, sort of the origins of this project.
You bet. So our project is located in the historic Warren Mining District of Idaho. It's in central Idaho. And Sidney Resources really has been working extensively the last couple of decades on this project. We've expanded from a small footprint to now over 208 acres of private ground and a little over 4,000 acres of mining claims. It's a gold, silver, PGM, and rare earth deposit. So pretty significant, but we've been doing a lot of study, a lot of research, and we're essentially on the doorstep of moving into production.
Yeah, and the key part of this is a really important one for the United States, for the company, obviously, but it's an important one for the world in general. Is that a fair way to say it?
I think that's a perfectly fair way to say it. When you look at particularly where the United States is in moving, both with past and present administrations, trying to really secure rare earths and critical minerals for U.S., national security issues, this fits the bill perfectly with the high concentrations of not only gold and silver, but all of the platinum group metals, including iridium and osmium and platinum and palladium, you know, all that play a key role. There's also a significant deposit for rare earths. And so when you combine those two pieces, as well as this project launching a way to move it forward rapidly, is with over 300,000 tons of old mine spoils that are contain high grade levels of all of these components. We can also do a large mine cleanup and recover these during that process, which has significance in the area of clean water and clean soil. So that's a big part of this, but really showing the mining world that you can do things a little bit different and still be highly successful. So it really does make a national and a global impact.
I know that there's a lot of work going on the metallurgical side. Maybe talk to me a bit about where you're at on that and kind of the work that's going on between you and a partner.
Oh, you bet. So our partner, our main contractor, is Western Frontier. And so we've been working with them some time. But originally, we had looked at this as a gold-silver deposit until our senior geologist, Steve Dobson, recognized signs of a meteor strike, which is where a lot of the complexity of this comes from. So instead of just being gold and silver, you now have all of the different platinum group metals that are alloyed in. And so that's created some complexities, but it's not impossible. So what we've been working on, we set up our own lab. So we're doing testing from everything from grind studies to where we've now successfully been able to separate the gold, silver, platinum, and palladium from these alloyed materials, which is huge. It's a six-step process, and it's using some really ancient techniques combined with modern methodologies that we're actually looking at trademarking and patenting this process. It's so unique, but it's highly successful. We've been able to recover those, and what we're working on now is moving into the stoichiometry, which is essentially figuring out the recipe to be able to take this from small scale testing to commercial levels for recovery and then refining.
Yeah. And with that, as you mentioned, is that remediation part as well. And it all fits in together as the story of the project, right?
Well, it does. And, you know, one of the original goals of Sidney Resources as a corporation is to change the way mining is done. You know, we've worked on, we have some laser technology that we've been developing, but really it's about changing the way mining practices are done. And that's where we've even lessened the footprint that we've made in the exploration side. So instead of doing a lot of high cost drilling, what the team has done is we've looked at historical production records and really let the old miners that worked back in there from 1862, they did the drilling. And we can look at their results and what the mine spoils are. But so much of this is showing the world that we can do mining in an environmentally responsive way, include the conservation groups, the tribes in the area, the federal agencies, the state agencies, to complete a massive reclamation project with cutting-edge bioremediation tools to meet strategic critical minerals and rare earth needs for the United States and potentially for the globe.
Yeah, and part of that is also infrastructure on the ground, and I know you that's been a part of the company's process over the last little while as well, is just making sure you can get to where you want to go.
No, yeah, because right now it's a long ways in the middle of nowhere. Right, going to work is a 52-mile snowmobile ride in the winter. And so it's looking at what infrastructure is there existing, and they got horses and wagons in there in the old days. Well, those typically followed waterways or what are referred to as riparian zones. And so in what we've been developing is instead of using those traditional old paths to these mine sites, is we've been designing, we've completed road design for new access to our Lucky Bend project, which is where we'll house a smaller processing facility to deal with some stockpiles that are close by. And then also a second road that provides access to our private property, where we'll house larger facilities. And what that does is allow us to move these roads out of these riparian zones, eliminate water crossings, and at the same time plan for obliteration of existing roads, which is going to eliminate silt and the different components, and really tie into meeting goals of conservation groups as well as the tribes, and hopefully the world in general of let's clean some stuff up and do a better job with it.
Absolutely. You can retire your horse and buggy now, is what you're saying. So,
There you go,
hey, Dan, thanks for the update. Really appreciate it. Very exciting work that's going on. I know we're gonna have lots of conversations over the next little while and getting everyone up to date with where you're at, but it's a good to get everyone on the right page as to where you are right now. So appreciate your time.
You betcha, and thank you. It's always a pleasure. Have a great rest of your day.
You as well. Dan Hally, the COO of Sidney Resources.